A homomorphism is a way to compare two groups for structural similarities. It's a function between two groups which preserves the group structure in each group. Let's be more specific. Suppose we have two groups G and H. Remember, G and H are different groups, and they may have entirely different group operations. To help us keep G and H separate in our minds, let's use an asterisk for the group operation in G and a diamond for the group operation in H. We'll still use the word times, but we'll write the correct symbol for the operation. Now pick any two elements x and y in G. Let's say that x times y equals z. Next, suppose we have a function f that maps g to h. The three elements, x, y, and z, are mapped to elements in h. X is mapped to f of x, y is mapped to f of y, and z is mapped to f of z. The whole point of a homomorphism is to find a structural similarity between two groups. So if x times y equals z in G, then we'd like f of x times f of y to be equal to f of z in the group H. But z equals x times y. Substituting this gives us f of x times f of y equals f of x times y. This is a definition of a homomorphism. It's a simple definition, but it captures a big idea. A way to compare two groups. Let's see an example. Let G be the group of real numbers under addition, and H be the positive real numbers under multiplication. G is an abelian group with identity element 0, and H is an abelian group with identity element 1. Here's a homomorphism. Define the function f that maps x to e to the x. To make sure this is a homomorphism, we need to verify that f of x plus y equals f of x times f of y. Don't forget that the group operation for g is addition, while the group operation for h is multiplication. By the definition of f, this says that e to the x plus y equals e to the x times e to the y. And this is true. This is one of the rules of exponents. So f is a homomorphism. Here's another example of a homomorphism. G will be the real numbers under addition, and H will be the complex numbers with absolute value 1. These complex numbers form a group under multiplication. Showing this is a good exercise, so why don't you pause the video and show that H is a group? Here's a hint. Every complex number with absolute value 1 can be written as e to the I theta for some angle theta. Define the function f as f of x equals e to the ix. For f to be a homomorphism, we must have f of x plus y equals f of x times f of y. This is true only if e to the I times x plus y equals e to the ix times e to the iy. We can see this is true by expanding the left-hand side. Then using the rules of exponents. It's true, f is a homomorphism. By the way, I'd like to point out that f of 0 equals f of 2 pi. Both are equal to 1. In fact, f of any multiple of 2 pi is 1. So this is not a one-to-one function. Homomorphisms do not have to be one-to-one. Take a closer look at the word homomorphism. It's a combination of homo, which means same, and morph, which means shape. But don't be misled by this name. If two groups are homomorphic, it doesn't mean they're the same. It just means they're similar. Also, not every pair of groups will have a non-trivial homomorphism between them. Some groups are so different from one another, there are no structural similarities at all. One final note. How would you simplify this expression? Well, the square root of negative 1 is I, so this leaves us with I subscribe. I'm so sorry for that. I did not.